So joined here today by Paul Shellard from the National Education Union. Welcome back, Paul. Bit of developments there with the Moulsecoomb Primary School. I spoke to Hannah Clare about this, the Deputy Leader of the Council, but I know you're going to give us a further update on the academisation of Moulsecoomb Primary School, because it's going ahead, isn't it? And as you rightly predicted last time we spoke.
Well, at the moment, it's due to be going ahead, but we'll be doing everything we can to stop it. What happened was that the Regional Schools Commission informed us that there were three potential academy sponsors who'd come forward and that they'd be making a decision. They delayed making a decision and referred the matter to Baroness Berridge, one of the government ministers. And then subsequently, it was decided that the Pioneer Academy would be offered the sponsorship or would be appointed as the sponsor for Moulsecoomb School. So that happened a few weeks ago. When that decision was made, I think the CEO of the Pioneer Academy, Lee Mason Ellis, has received well over 1,000 letters or emails from people with a kind of clear message, which is that they should withdraw from the process, like the three other academy sponsors who've shown interest in it before. But at the moment, officially what's going on is there's a period of due diligence. And today, of course, was the first visit to the school by the Pioneer Academy. And the parents campaign, the Hands Off Moulsecoomb Primary campaign, has blocked the gates at the school. So there's been a delay in the Pioneer Academy school actually we're getting in to Moulsecoomb Primary. Right. And of course, this also follows. There have been 4 days of strike action in total by teachers and support staff in NEU, GMB and Unison. And two of those have been taken since the announcement of the Pioneer Academy.
Yeah, so that's quite big news then. So do you think that kind of direct action will make any difference? I mean, ultimately, you just need the current education secretary, who is Gavin Williamson, to kind of overturn the academy order. I think that's the only way forward over the long term. Is that right?
It is right that, and we've called on the Secretary of State to overturn the Academy ruling. We've also argued that Ofsted should be able to come back to give a full inspection. And if the school is judged to be good, and we consider, and there's evidence, because there's been three monitoring visits, that it has continued on a trajectory of improvement, that they should revoke that academy order. And that has happened in other cases. But unfortunately, at the same time, the government seems determined to try to step up its academisation programme. And that's because it has fallen now to a trickle. So they're now trying all sorts of measures, like the try before you buy that was announced last week, to try to sort of encourage schools to become academies. But it's quite clear that the Moulsecoomb community, parents and carers and staff, no one wants there to be this academy takeover. The ballot, which was 96% of parents voting against academisation, which was taken a while ago now, but feelings are running even stronger. People want to stay within the Brighton and Hove family of schools.